Hey guys, welcome to my channel. And today's look is very Middle Eastern style, the Arab beauty style inspired. And Eid is around the corner, so I thought I'll do this amazing golden smoky eye, which is very appropriate for this coming Eid festival. And a lot of Arab makeup artists and a lot of Middle Eastern girls do very similar look, and they have this really bold eye and really bold lips, contoured and chiseled face, and all these kind of jazz. So I hope you like this tutorial, and I have worked really hard. This is the longest tutorial that I have ever done, and my battery is about to die, so I thought of making this short intro and talk to you guys because it's been a while since I did a look. So guys, let me know how you like this, and leave your suggestions down below. I hope that I get to inspire some of you. So alright guys, my battery is about to die, so if you are interested in this tutorial, then just keep watching. So I'm going to start off with this primer. This is the Nature Pure Mineral Face Primer. Before that, I did moisturize my face as well as lips, just so you know. And I'm actually pressing it onto my skin, not rubbing it. Moving on, I'm going to prime my eyes with this LA Girl Pro Conceal Concealer. I'm just focusing on both the corners of the eyes because my dark circles have worsened now, and I'm blending it with the Beauty Blender. I'm taking this Sleek Eye Divine mineral based eyeshadow palette, Ultra Mattes palette V2731, that's the full name, and I'm going to take this eyeshadow in the shade Paperback. This is a very dark brown color, and I'm going to fill in the sparse areas of my brows just to make it more intense. That's what Middle Eastern girls do. They have really dark brows. And I'm going to take this one, which I'm pointing at. It's the shade Flesh, and I'm going to set all the concealer with this. I'm just going to lock it off. I'm just creating a blank canvas for my eyes. I'm going to zoom you guys in a little bit and doing the same thing. Just lock everything. And that color is called Maple, which I pointed at. It's very little bit auburnish, reddish, mauvey color. And I'm going with a crease, tapered crease brush, and I'm just going to intensify that crease. You can use any colors in the crease according to your wish. You really do not have to use what I have. Any similar color or anything would do. And after that, I'm taking both those colors, that is Paperback as well as Villain. So I'm just mixing both of them and taking a blending brush by Real Techniques, and I'm going to go on the outer V. I'm going to buff it in the outer V so that it just gets a little smoked out. And in this process, the lid is left blank, completely blank, and I'm going to clean up the inner half of my eyes using the same flesh colored eyeshadow. And you can use any color which is your skin tone, basically anything works fine. I'm going to diffuse the edges using the same flesh eyeshadow. I'm taking this Urban Decay Shadow Box eyeshadow palette, and I selected this really shimmery pigmented eyeshadow. This is called Baked Cowboy, and I'm going all over the lid. I actually wet my brush with a fixing mist, and that really intensifies how this eyeshadow looks. So I would always suggest, if you guys are going for lid color and you want shimmers, always wet the brush before you use it. I'm going all over the lid. As you can see in the outer V, we have all those dark colors, but I'm going over that space as well when I'm using this Baked Cowboy color, because this really helps
widen your eyelid area. And I'm going with this flesh color again from the Sleek Makeup eyeshadow palette, and I'm just diffusing the edges again. I don't want it to be harsh because this is not a cut crease that we're going for. This is a very golden smoky eye kind of look. And I'm taking this blackout eyeshadow from this Urban Decay shadow box, and I'm going in the outer V to intensify that smoky eye and just give this very glamorous and very nighttime appropriate look. And guys, this is a Middle Eastern inspired look which is perfect for Eid, but you can use it for any other occasion. It's not just limited to Eid. And I'm going with this baked cowboy again to intensify that really foiled look. And in the inner corners, I'm actually going to take this first color which I'm pointing at. This is called Sin. And I'm going to take a pencil brush from Real Techniques. And I'm going in the inner corners as well as the brow bone to highlight. I'm just highlighting it very subtly, but all depends on how you like it. And I'm actually going to take these two colors which I used in the outer V, the paper bag as well as maple. I'm going to tight line it in the lower lash line first, and I'm going to blend it all out using flesh. So basically whatever color you use in your upper eye, you just have to use the darker colors in the tight line and blend it all out with a normal color, like light color. So I'm going to use a lighter color shade. This is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation for the areas where I would highlight my face. So I'm using that foundation to highlight, and I'm using a darker color, that's the Lotus Herbals Mineral Pure Stay Foundation, where I would contour. So I'm actually not taking just one foundation today. I'm actually going to cream contour, so that's why I'm using those perimetered area. I'm taking a darker color, and the highlighting area I'm taking a foundation, and I'm going to blend it all out. And I'm going to take this LA Girl Pro Conceal over my foundation, and I'm going to blend everything out so that I get a really sculpted and really nice contoured look with the foundation itself. So this is a way to cream contour, guys. If you are interested in this, you can use darker color in the perimeters and wherever you are contouring, and lighter colors in the highlighting zone. I'm actually taking this concealer stick. It's by Makeup Revolution, the Cover and Conceal Matte Effect Concealer Stick, and over that actually I used it to contour furthermore, and I'm going to blend it all out. And I'm taking this Bahama Mama bronzer. I'm going to lock that concealer and that contour, whatever we did, the cream contour, I'm going to lock it all out with the Bahama Mama bronzer. And you can see that I didn't powder my face. That's because I'm going to do it right now after we contour, because I'm just locking the cream contours and everything. So I'm going to lock the highlighting part as well, but I'll be doing it with a beauty blender. So I'm going to dip my beauty blender into a setting powder, and I'm going to go over under my eyes. And after that, I'm actually moving on to my gel liner. This is the Maybelline Eye Studios gel liner, and Middle Eastern makeup really includes that dramatic eye. Like, that's why I'm going overboard, because I wouldn't normally make such dramatic eye, but today I did. And for my mascara, I'm taking this Bobbi Brown Extreme Party Mascara, and in this process I felt that little highlight was needed, so I took the same color Sin eyeshadow by Urban Decay and I highlighted it furthermore. And I'm going with falsies, of course. Arabic and Middle Eastern makeup is not complete without the drama in the eyes, basically. So yeah, we're going with falsies. This is the Ardell's Jemmy Lacies. So I'm going to let it out to dry, and you can use any highlighter which you like to highlight, but not too much. Middle Eastern makeup has very subtle highlight, so I'm using this one from Makeup Revolution, the Golden Bricks Baked Bronzer, and I'm just going a little bit on the nose, on the high points of cheeks, center of forehead and stuff. And for my lips, I'm taking this Huda Beauty lip contour in the shade Video Star, and I'm actually going to overline this a little bit because that's what it's all about in Middle East. Really nice and juicy lips and bold eyes is all that jazz. So I'm going to overline a little bit, and I actually am going to use another lipstick over this because that's the trend these days. I'm taking this L'Oreal Paris Color Rich Elle Extraordinaire Matte. That's one hell of a name. So it's a soft matte color which looks very glossy, but throughout the day it does fade into matte. But it's not going to be like a liquid lipstick, but it's going to be a little bit glossy. Ultimately it does turn matte. I'm going to lock it all out with a fixing mist. This is by MUA Makeup Academy. You can find it on Jabong. So this is the whole look, guys. Let me know what you think of it.
Alright guys, so this was my Middle Eastern inspired makeup look, and if you guys liked it, please thumbs up. And if you randomly came across my channel and you have no idea who I am, then please subscribe and check out my other videos. I'll link a few here and I will link some in the description as well. And just follow me on all the social media like Instagram and Facebook, Twitter, etc. I'm always active there. And I'll see you guys really, really soon in my next one. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye, have a good day, and Eid Mubarak.